Let's get started making a book by tapping on the Book Creator app icon. Go ahead and tap on New Book up at the top. Now let's choose from the page layout templates available in Book Creator. Choose Portrait if you want a vertically oriented book. Choose Square for square books, and choose Landscape for horizontal layout books. If you're using the free version of Book Creator, tap on one of the book layout templates in the top row. Tapping on one of the book layout templates in the bottom row will cause Book Creator to give you an upgrade to the full version of Book Creator notice. You can choose whichever one you want by tapping on it. I'm going to tap on Landscape. Now we're on the title page of our book, so let's add some text. You can add things to the pages of your book in Book Creator by tapping on the plus on the top menu bar. Here you can see what sorts of media you can add to your book. Let's start out by adding a photo to our book. You can view the photos that you want to add to your book by moments, your entire camera roll, or any albums that you already have set up in your Photos app. I'm going to tap on this album and I'm going to grab a photo of myself. Hi everybody, it's me. Now that your photo is added to your page, you can grab on any of the blue corner handles and push in on those and drag your photo to be smaller or larger, whatever you like. And then you can drag the photo around on your page until it matches up with any of these guides so that you can see if it is horizontally centered on the page, if it is vertically centered on the page, or it could be anywhere that you want it to be on the page. If your photo is not selected and you want to move it around again, just go ahead and tap on the photo until you see the blue handles and the blue border on your photo, and then you'll be able to move it around on the page again and readjust it. Let's go ahead and add some text to our cover as well. So tap on the plus menu up in that top menu bar. Tap on Add Text in the media menu. In the text editor box that pops up, you can type in whatever text you'd like to have on your cover page. I'm going to create an All About Me book, so I will go ahead and type that in. You can type in whatever text that you would like in your book as you're creating it. Once you're finished adding your text, go ahead and tap on Done at the top right. And that will add that text to the page. Again, if it is highlighted with the blue border, you can grab it and drag it around the page with your finger. You might want that text to be larger though. So while the text is selected with that blue border, tap on the Inspector button at the top. That's the small eye with the circle around it. On the Inspector menu, you can make the text larger by dragging the little slider to the right, or make it smaller by dragging it to the left, whatever you want it to be, so that it fits your book. You can make your text bold, italic, or underlined by tapping on any of those options. You can change your font by tapping next to Font and selecting from any of the font styles that are available there. Tap on Back once you're finished selecting your font. You can change the color of your font by tapping in the color well. So maybe instead of standard black, you might want to have a different color for your text. If you want more than the 12 standard colors shown there, you can tap on the More button. And then you can slide your finger around this spectrum to choose the exact color of text that you want. And at the bottom, you can move the slider from left to right to make that color brighter or darker. Once you're finished selecting your color, go ahead and tap on Apply at the top. And then tap on the color button to go back to the color menu. Book Creator will keep track of the last 8 colors that you've used, so those ink wells at the bottom will show your last color selections, and you can choose your color from there as well. Once you're finished changing your color, tap on the back button at the top. You could also align your text by choosing left justified, center justified, right justified. And if you had other elements on this text, like maybe shapes, you could move your text in front of or behind other shapes. You could also delete this text box if you really don't want that on the page. I'm going to go ahead and tap on the page just to close up this inspector menu for the text. And then to make my text show up on the page, I'm going to grab one of those blue handles and I'm just going to drag it to be wider so that all of my text shows on the page. Once you're finished formatting your text, just go ahead and tap anywhere on the page to unselect your text. If you want to undo any of the formatting or changes that you've made to your book, you can tap on the Undo button in the top menu bar to step backward through those steps and changes that you've made to your book. I'm going to go ahead though and redo those changes to this font so that all of my font shows on the page. Let's go ahead and add some pages to our book. From the cover, you can tap on that right chevron on the right side to turn the page. Let's add some text to this page. So go ahead and tap on the plus icon at the top of the page. Tap on Add Text. In your All About Me book, you probably want to add something about maybe your room or hobbies that you like or what you teach. I don't really have a room, so I will write something about my desk area. Once you're finished typing your text, again, tap on Done at the top right. And then to format that text again, tap on the Inspector button at the top right. Here I'm going to make that text a little smaller so that it doesn't overlap. I'll tap off of that menu. You can notice that Book Creator does remember the last color and size and formatting of my text that I added to the page, so I don't have to constantly be going back and reformatting everything. So I'll tap on the page to close that menu. Again, I can pull on those blue handles and I can move my text around the page by dragging it and then tap off of it when you're finished. Let's tap on the plus menu and add another photo. Go to photos again. Again, I'm going to go down to my album. You could go to camera roll and grab a photo. So I have a couple photos of my desk area that I can add. And you need to add these one at a time. So there's my exciting desk. Again, I can resize that by grabbing these little blue handles on the corner and dragging the photo around to wherever I want on the page. I'll go back to the plus menu, back to photos, back to my album, and add the other view of my desk area. So there's my laptop and a monitor. I'll resize that one as well and move it around the page. Just get those kind of positioned there. You can add another page to your book by tapping again on the right chevron on the right side. Let's tap on the plus menu at the top. And maybe we want to add a photo that we don't have right now in our Photos app or our camera roll. So we can tap on camera there in our media menu and we could take a live photo. So tapping on camera will activate our camera on our iPad. And when we have the photo that we want, go ahead and tap on the shutter button on the right side to take a photo. And then you'll notice that along the bottom edge on the left side, you'll see retake. Go ahead and tap on retake if you don't like your photo and you want to take it over. And then just repeat that process. Or on the right side, go ahead and tap on use photo if you're happy with this photo and want to use it in your book. I'm going to tap on use photo. And again, there's my photo. I can resize it with the blue handles in the corner and I can adjust that and move it around on my page in Book Creator. Let's go ahead and add another page to our book by tapping on the plus sign on the right. Now you'll notice now instead of having that chevron or arrow on the right side, we have a plus sign. That's because Book Creator comes with two pages every time that you create a new book. And if you want to add more than 2 pages to your book, then you'll need to tap on the plus sign. Let's go up to the plus menu again at the top. And maybe we want to add some video to our book. Now, if we had our video already, maybe we created it with the camera app at some point earlier, we could go to photos and we could select that video from our camera roll or from an album if you've added the video to an album. But again, maybe we don't have the video. So let's go ahead and tap on camera in our media menu, and that will activate our camera on our iPad. Swipe from photo to video on the right side of your iPad to switch to the video camera. Once your iPad is focused, you can tap on the red shutter button to start recording your video. After you've recorded whatever you want in your video, tap the red shutter button again to end your video. Tap on the play button, the bottom center, to watch your video to make sure that it works for you. If your video isn't what you want, you can tap the retake button in the bottom left corner of the screen to start over. If your video is okay, then go ahead and tap use video at the bottom right to insert your video into your book. At this point, I could grab those blue handles, I could resize my video, I could drag the video around on the page and get it positioned exactly where I want it to be.